Hello, everybody. What's going on? This is Will here, and we're approaching the island that we actually have to get to. Also, I have a sore throat. It is official. My throat is sore. It is full of sickness. So, it doesn't hurt to talk, though. So what I'm really going to do is just, you know, kind of have these next few episodes, not necessarily episodes, but videos, just be a little more slack and, you know, not as much, super broadcasty sounding voices. Maybe you guys will enjoy that. Look, Will, do you see it? What has happened to this place? I don't know, man. Let's check it out. Ooh. Look at all the wreckage everywhere. Oh. This place got fuffed up. What is the meaning of this? The island. It is. We are too late. I knew we had precious little time, but I never suspected how little. A great water spirit named Jibon. Jibon? Jibon, maybe? Once lived here, but no sign of him remains. Boy! Ho there, Will! Oh man, who's calling me? Oh, it's one of the Rito! Oh, I think it's, Oh yeah, I think it's Quill. I actually remembered his name this time. Well, that's good. I remembered his name. Alright, hey Jared, what's up? So you're here, I've been looking for you. Are you by chance seeking the great spirit Jibon? I'm sorry to report to you that Jibon can no longer be found here. Just look at how this place has been torn to pieces. I suppose this too is the work of the Shadow and Forsaken Fortress. But fear not, Jibon was able to flee this island before it was attacked. He's in a safer abode now. Would you like to guess where that abode may be? On the island where you were born. On Outset. Dude, that's friggin' crazy, man! And if something's out there trying to kill Jibon, then... Oh no, our island's in danger. That's no good. We're gonna have to find a way to... Okay, so Quill's saying something about a mighty stone slab that we have to get out of the way. I thought if anyone would know your whereabouts, it would be the pirates. Oh. Oh, so you're trying to get the pirates to help out. Okay. I don't know where they hoped to get. I don't know what they hoped to get. But they immediately set sail for Outset Island and tried to break into the cave. It is lucky they could not gain entrance. I've heard that they were last spotted on Windfall Island. Okay. You wish to see Jibon, I think you'd better search for the pirates on Windfall Island. What an eerie isle this is. Everywhere else boasts clear skies and calm seas, but this place suffers under dark clouds and rain. Baloo must have been right when he asked me to bring word of Jibon to you. He called this island cursed. Whoa, man. That's friggin' messed up. I would counsel against staying here longer than you have to. But that is your decision. I told you Jibon, so my task is complete. Dude, that's such a cool friggin' camera angle. So badass. And that one thing he says always scared me about, like, how not to stay here very long. Just because you really do get that... I hate to sound like I'm making a pun, I'm really not trying to. That foreboding feel. Like, you really do get that feeling of foreboding around here. It's crazy. So, Jibon has survived. The sea spirit has lived through the trials many long years. He must have caught wind of Ganon's attack beforehand. Caught wind. Okay. And the pirates know something about the cave. Alright, well that's a good start then. And we know that they're in Windfall, so let's start with what we can do. Alright. So, Windfall is to the northeast. So let's get our wind direction changed here. Even in this violent storm, we're able to manipulate the wind. It's such a cool feeling. You control the storm, but you can't stop it. That is messed up. That is a quote for the history books. That is George Washington. Yeah, that's totally a George Washington quote, because, you know, I would know about that. Man, I can throw that boomerang freaking far. You can control the storm, but you can't stop it. George Washington. Imagine if that's, like, what he said about, like, the Revolutionary War or something. Or not the Revolution. Yeah, the Revolutionary War. Oh, man. Oh, gross. Oh, that sounds so jitty. Gross, man. Oh, just listen to that. You can hear the overworld music's in minor now. It's so gross. Set in a minor key, it all sounds so sinister and evil. And panicky. So weird. Alright, so we should be going the right way. Okay. So that must be Windfall Island in the distance there. We can see the silhouette. I don't remember quite being shaped like that, though. Maybe that's not it. I honestly don't think it is. It's kind of an odd shape. I know what Windfall Island looks like, and I don't recall it looking like that. No, definitely not. Oh, great. Yeah, so around this part of the game, you're gonna come across a lot more sharks than usual. And, you know, they're gonna try and ram your boat over, but it's pretty easy. Ugh. These freaking cyclones blowing me around all over the place with the balls, man. Not even a little bit cool. Not even a little bit useful. Not even a little bit of anything. Oh, that's Tingle Island. We don't have to worry about that place for quite a while. It is actually part of the story, though, so... When you're in Windfall Island, don't think that you're just doing that to get an optional item. You do really need to break Tingle out. So, you know, keep that in mind. Right, yeah, there's Windfall Island. Alright. What are we at here? Oh, we're only at 6 minutes. We're doing pretty good. I was hoping that a lot of this episode wasn't going to be taken up just by, you know, pirate... Or not pirate. I was hoping it was going to be full of pirate stuff. I was hoping it wasn't going to be too full of, like, boating stuff. Because I know that this section of the game does have two sailing sections fairly close to one another that are both very pivotal to the story, so, like, I don't want to cut them out or anything. This freaking shark, man. Can somebody get this shark the balls out of here? Friggin' look at him. Look at him go. Look at him swimming around like a speeding car. Look at him swimming, because, you know, cars swim. That's a logical explanation, I think. What's this? What the heck was that? I don't quite know what just happened. Is that a thing? Oh, yeah, because... Alright, yeah, because you gotta... It activates, like, a... Not a cutscene, but... It, like, reloads the whole overworld so that the pirate ship is over here. On Windfall Island. I believe that's why they do that. That's the only explanation I can come up with. Gotta be it. I really should be talking to more of those fish splashing around in the water and like dropping the bait in there and getting the information on the map. I really should be doing more of that because I only have 4 of the locations identified. Should really be doing more of that. Alright. So here we are. Back where we started. It is just as the postman told us. The pirate ship has stopped here to avoid drawing the attention of the townsfolk. Yeah, because that giant pirate ship won't draw any attention. I know not what they are researching, but if they are hoping to get their hands on Jaybun's sacred gem, I doubt they would tell you anything directly if you were to ask them. Will, I think you should try to find out what the pirates are up to, without them finding out about you. Alright man, that sounds like a good idea. I always found this to be a rather, cryptic part of the game. It took me a while to figure this out, but then again, I was stupid at this game, so that really doesn't say much at all. But, your first instinct, obviously, will be to go over to the pirate ship. You know, take a little jump in and stuff, and try to go in here, maybe. Who cleans pirates' ears? Pardon me? Oh. Church? I think? No, no, that's completely wrong. Now scram, non-pirate. Well, geez, man. I thought church was the answer for everything. That's obviously not what we're trying to do here. So, I guess our first plan, since we don't really have much we can do right now, not given much direction. We know that we have to find things out from the pirates without them noticing that I'm around. But we don't know where the pirates are. And apparently we need a password to get into the ship, but we don't have the password. Hmm. So if we can... Wait a second. Why is that building the only one that has the lights on inside? I didn't see any other windows that were on. Oh, never mind. There's actually one up there. There actually is, but anyway. I was trying to give a hint at where we're supposed to go by using logic, but it didn't work. We have to go into the building over here, so. But first we'll talk to our little post box here. Good evening! Letters for Will, we have one letter. Yeah, just barf it onto my hand, that's so freaking nasty. If you wish to be a true swordsman, find some knight's crests and return to me, Orca. Well, thanks, buddy. Thanks for the red rupee that I don't need. It's so inconsiderate of Link here. Like, frig, man. Like, he doesn't have room for it, so he's just like, oh, thanks for the present. Better throw it away. Like, you don't get that money back. Man. Link's kind of a dick. The fact that he just throws away gifts from people in the mail. In the mail, too. If someone sent me a gift through the mail, I would be, man, I'd be so happy. It just sounds like it'd be such a nice thing. You know? Anyway, we're gonna climb up here onto the viney, the underbelly of the, it's not even an underbelly, it's like a back belly. I don't, a back belly? That's some good logical thinking right there, Will. Alright, whoa! Oh my, this is a stick-up. This is a stick-up right now. Look, don't be mad at us, it's not our fault that we absolutely gotta have bombs to get the treasure we're after. How about you just think of it as payback for the nasty little monopoly you've been running here, yeah? Oh, snap! So I bet you're thinking it was foolhardy to ask pirates to pay such an outrageous price, huh? Yup, I bet you are. You know, Gonzo, I still can't get over that bit of fast-talking you pulled to get that information out of the postman. Aw, man, so this was all just part of their sneaky little plan? I didn't realize the pirates were bad guys. I tell you, the minute I set my eyes on that Will, I knew he was hiding something back at Outset, yeah? So when I saw that postman, I just pretended like I was all worried about the kid and stuff. And presto, he spills the beans. Well, dude, what the balls, man? Man, he thinks that I'm the one betraying everyone else. That's not at all what it is. Oh. Oh.
Oh my god.
Ew. Oh, that's weird. She's like a little kid. Oh, don't be. Ah. Oh, you freaking. Ugh. You listening to this? Oh my god. Dock him some pay. Pirates get paid like wages? Oh, snap. She doesn't think it's funny. Well, it's good to know that you guys will be robbing 3 bombs. That's always good. I think that'll be useful. What? We have to leave immediately, but it's been so long since we were on shore. Oh my god. And he's the nitwit. Are you seriously going to let leave a gaping hole in your plan by waiting overnight? One does not simply wait overnight. Remember that Diglett episode of Pokemon, like the original season? When freaking Pikachu needed the super potion, then Ash was going to the store, and then he got knocked out because he got smacked in the face by Gary. And then he was almost late. He was so late and his whole plan just went down the crapper. And it was all just because he slept overnight, man. You can't do that. You can't. Oh, Tucker's meowing. Whoa. I'll be honest, the first time I ever played this game, I thought that they completely bastardized Nico's face. Like, doesn't it look like that? Like, Nico just suddenly got really, like, rugged and, like, mean-looking? Kind of looks like that, doesn't it? Because he's wearing the same outfit and everything, pretty much. Anyway, he's got an awesome set of sideburns, so it's fine. I better let Tucker out. Alright. Okay, so, let's just keep going. Oh, there's some ellipses here. Uh-oh. You're all fools, do you know that? You saw the demolished island, you saw the senseless destruction. We have to hurry on to Outset, or the same thing could happen there. Oh, so they're concerned about that great fish eel we were at. Isle. Okay, you're worried more about that island than the treasure. Well, it was where you were dropped. It holds a lot of sentimental value. The treasure. Uh-oh, she saw us! Oh my god. Oh, she's keeping it a secret! Oh, she's playing along! Alright, fine, have it your way. We can leave town tomorrow, you big babies. But we're setting sail at first light, so no sleeping in, understood? Oh my god! I love that one guy. that's how you say aye-aye, right? Oh! We're getting some intel, dude! Say there, brother, what was today's password again? Are you serious? You forgot already? You're so useless. Damn. Swabbies. Aw, that's nice. You know that Nika won't let you in if you don't say it exactly right. And he's real picky about it, so it must be case sensitive. Okay, Swabbies. Alright, so it has a capital S. So I gotta keep note of that. Swabbies, eh? Man, they give it to you like 3 times. They really don't want it to be on their butts if you get it wrong. Man, that is like the equivalent of video game insurance right there. Well, dude, apparently you were overselling these by a long shot. So, dude, shame on you. We're not even gonna help you. We can't even talk. We can't talk, man. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, that's just the way it's gonna be. Oh man, I'm getting a runny nose from all this talking, apparently. And that's the end of the episode, I guess, because my throat can't take much more of it right now. Right now, at least. I'll definitely keep doing this, but I'll be keeping my voice down like I've been doing. I hope you all have a very good life. Or afterlife, if you're the back belly of this bomb shop. In the next episode, I couldn't even think, what would a back belly do? So it's just, if you are, then you're obviously dead. Because back bellies aren't alive. Peace.